really a great pleasure and honor indeed for me to deliver an oration in the name of none other than Dr. Bijoy Khandaria. I pay my tribute to Dr. Bijoy Khandaria for his contribution in echocardiography in the world. The main agenda of my presentation is to highlight on the AF burden in India and the real world, why, when, and where to recommend echocardiographic navigation of atrial fibrillation right from the slurring of speech and to the irregular pulse, and to highlight on the diagnostic, prognostic, and therapeutic implications, and to highlight the potentials of various echo variables throughout, taking into consideration the LA strain, LA volume, and LA clot, LA velocity, and of course the various hemodynamics, timely and therapeutic intervention to reduce the premature morbidity and mortality produced by the stroke. The global and the Asian burden is very well known to you, varies from 2% to 10%. As the age advances, the burden of AF rises. And the most common cause is hypertension, heart failure, and metabolic syndrome. And we see here 14 crore AF patients are seen worldwide. Enormous data. One out of four adults in Europe and USA develop AF in their lifetime. 20% of strokes are cardioembolic, and 90% of NVAF has LA clot. Global burden of AF, dominance we see here is more in males as compared to females, and we see the mortality is just the reverse. The mortality is more in females as compared to males. The global AF mortality, which has been shown in developed countries, is different as compared to developing countries. In developing countries, the female is dominant, while the in developed countries, male dominance for the reasons not known. The Asian burden is rising day by day. In 2015, Asia is going to be number one. AF burden, based on ethnicity, is seen more in whites as compared to blacks. This is just to show that the Asians are a high risk for AF. And it's very clear that the CAT score more than 2 is not enough. It is the LA appendage evaluation, LAVI, LA strain rate, and LAA velocity is a must for every stroke AF evaluation. The worldwide mortality is very well known to us by ischemic heart disease and stroke, and there is a definite relationship of AF in the rising prevalence of stroke and CVD in India, shown by WHO very clearly. Now, if you see the economic impact, if you see the stroke rate, heart failure, dementia, and mortality, as well as re-hospitalization is very high in patients with atrial fibrillation. And the data is very clear that the AF burden adds $26 billion of US healthcare in the country. The question is, how to investigate why echo in atrial fibrillation evaluation always comes to our mind? As the patient comes, we want to know what is the etiology, what is the underlying treatment required, what is the stroke risk, which anticoagulant to use, warfarin or DOAC, should they be cardioverted, should they not be cardioverted, what is the extent of involvement of the LA appendage or LAA, will this patient revert successfully or will it not revert successfully, are the various questions which come in our mind. Each question can be answered by echo navigation. Etiology can be seen. We can evaluate very nicely the LA and the LA thrombus, intracardiac hemodynamics, LA size, LA strain rate, and stroke risk can be easily evaluated. You can take at any point of time. The various etiological factors are very well known to you. Rheumatic heart disease, the most common cause. And we see the low atrial fibrillation in India quite common. In acute MR, and of course, restrictive cardiomyopathy, you've seen in last many speakers have spoken on this. LA appendage evaluation is a must. LAVI evaluation is also a must. We see here the 2D TEE sensitivity is almost 100%, and the specificity is 90%. And the most important thing is, longer is the duration of atrial fibrillation, more is the prevalence of LA clot. And if you see here, the various types of LA appendage should be known to us, whether it's a cauliflower, where the embolic rate is high. If it is chicken wing, it's 48% have embolic risk. And of course, the various lobes should also be evaluated. 60% of rheumatic and 90% of non-rheumatic have a common prevalence of clot in the what we call as LA appendage. The LA scan is very, very important. And we should try to angulate from every angle possible, right from the apex to the base should be evaluated to see for any minor or major fragment of the clot there. Biplane imaging by 3D even helps us more, so that we can be very, very sure. And no patient should be cardioverted without having a thorough echo navigation. Spontaneous cardiac contrast echo is very well known to all of us. And there was a huge data which was presented by Ravi Kaskliwal and group in one of the BMJ in 1995, that the spontaneous contrast risk is very, very common, very, very well evaluated by TEE. And we can see a sac or a non-sac. We can see a minor or major fragments of a clot. Similarly, 3D echo is very, very important. And it is superior in many ways, more accurate, unlimited planes. It's comprehensive. We can see LA appendix clot evaluation in great details. We can even see whether the thrombi, is it sensitive or a non-sensitive? Is it resistant or a non-resistant? Calcified or a non-calcified? Is it degenerative? Is there any lysis of clots? Or even the mobility and the volume can be evaluated in great details. The LA size measurement, as I mentioned to you, is very, very important. We can use the various methods like the biplane Simpson's method. And the LA volume is also equally very, very important. And we know the cutoff point of 34 ml per square meter is very, very important, LA volume. LA volume by 3D is like a glycosylated hemoglobin of heart failure is also a very, very important for atrial fibrillation. And atrial fibrillation increases as the LAVI is more than 34 with a high morbidity and mortality. 3D, LA volume evaluation by 3D is very, very important because that may really predict the outcome of the patient, both from the cardiac morbidity as well as from the brain morbidity and mortality. And we can see which patient is vulnerable to go into cardiogenic shock or a long-term survival of 5 years. Everything can be assessed. This is our own data published in Indian Heart Journal. We have shown that when the LAVI is more than 34, the LV diastolic dysfunction is directly proportional to the size of the LAVI. LAVI is a prognostic value and a strongest independent predictor of the risk for CHF, CVA, all-cause mortality, as well as cardiac mortality. Very, very powerful parameter. Now, LA strain and LA velocity and LA stiffness index are the latest variables, a measure of LA deformation. We see more the stiffer the LA, more is the prevalence of AF. And more reduction of the LA strain, higher is the resistance to a cardioversion reversion, and the success rate is rather low. We see here, LA strain when reduced to less than 25 is highly vulnerable to have atrial fibrillation recurrence. Decreased LA strain predicts that the patient has a higher prevalence of recurrence and they are resistant to the cardioversion success. And they predict the occurrence of AF after CABG, valve surgery, and non-cardiac surgery. The prediction is very, very high. Decreased LA reduction may also give us an idea which patients are more vulnerable to a high stroke risk. There is a huge data to support that the stroke risk prognostic implications are possible to understand once we know the degree of the LA strain. Decreased LA strain, the prognosis is very, very poor. Huge data which has been shown by the literature. Left atrial strain, a new predictor for thrombotic risk and successful electrocardioversion. Meta-analysis of 8 studies have shown that decrease in LA strain, that the recurrence of AF is very, very common. Whatever method we use, cardioversion, radio frequency ablation, the recurrence rate is very, very high. This is what has been shown again. Ladies and gentlemen, the power and potential of LA strain in AF evaluation should not be underestimated. It is huge, preclinical as well as the clinical setting. We can predict fibrotic CMP, thromboembolism, atrial dysfunction, stroke risk, paroxysmal atrial fibrillation, cardioversion success, persistent of AF, radio frequency success, as well as the AF recurrence and heart failure, and paroxysmal atrial fibrillation to persistent atrial fibrillation after CABG and non-cardiac surgery, even overcause mortality and cardiac mortality can be predicted by decrease in the LV strain. LV strain are very well known to all of you, twist and untwist, And both global longitudinal strain, circumferential longitudinal strain, as well as the radial longitudinal strain also predict the atrial fibrillation rate. Recently, new work is going on, atrial stiffness index. It's a ratio of E by E prime ratio upon the LA strain rate. And if it's more than 1.1, its sensitivity is 84% and specificity is 100%. LA velocity, a lot of work has been done by our own colleague, Dr. Krishnam Raju, sitting right before me. And I think it's shown very clearly, LA velocity of less than 20 centimeters are more prone to have a thrombolic episodes and a strong predictor of thrombus formation and the risk of embolic events when the LA velocity is less than 20. LA velocity of more than 31 centimeters per second, the cardioversion success rate is high. Very, very obvious and documented by our own colleagues in Indian Heart Journal. LA stunning phenomena is also known to us. We've seen usually after radio frequency ablation and having a higher prevalence of thromboembolic events, the improvement of LA stunning after cardioversion completely takes 1 to 4 weeks. This is the algorithm from Dr. Naveen Sinanda's book and chapter, which is very clear that how a patient can be evaluated very well by TTE and TEE to evaluate the LV and LA thrombus and accordingly plan the line of treatment and cardioversion. This was the atrial fibrillation update which we released last year in the CSI, and this has gone as a huge data on echocardiographic navigation of atrial fibrillation. Ladies and gentlemen, to conclude, atrial fibrillation is a major public health problem with prevalence of almost 2% to 10%. And the most common cause in India is hypertension, diabetes, CAD, and heart failure. Echocardiographic navigation in atrial fibrillation is relevant in all stages. It has to be done repeatedly. It has a diagnostic, prognostic, and therapeutic implication. And most of the echo variables should be evaluated, LA, LA appendage, LAVI, LA strain, LA velocity, and of course, it's very important to understand the reduction in the LA strain is a robust echo variable for risk prediction of the recurrent AF and persistent AF. We can also predict the success of a radio frequency ablation in the EP lab. LA strain evaluation may optimize the selection of patient for radio frequency ablation, catheter ablation, or NOAC. It's very, very important. What's the take-home message? The message is health of millions is at stake with atrial fibrillation and stroke in India. And they go into a stroke which is non-reversible. So we have to be very careful in evaluation by 2D TEE and TTE and 3D TTE and 3D TEE. Echo variables I mentioned to you should be seen in detail. We must have a time to act and create echo AF protocol now in every hospital and every center. We should act locally if we really want to have an impact globally in reduction of AF-inflicted morbidity and mortality. Thank you very much for your kind attention.
JetWorks is here. Together, let's work towards a healthier India.